Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, creating your personal breakthrough, part two of two parts. And they come unto him, bringing one sick of palsy, which was born of four. And when they could not come nigh unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was. And when they had broken it up, they laid down the bed wherein the sick of palsy lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said unto the sick of palsy, Son, thy sins be forgiven thee. Mark 2, 3-5. In creating your personal breakthrough part 1, we talked about Jesus being in Capernaum with so many people listening to him that you could not even get into the door. There was a paralytic man who could not walk on his own, and four of his friends carried him to the house. They tore off a portion of the roof and they got him in with Jesus. The four men realized that for the man to get his healing, that he needed to be more than just in the vicinity of Jesus. So they took him up close. Many are content to be in the vicinity, but we must desire to get up close to where the Master does his work. Getting up close has its challenges, with so much in our lives pulling us constantly, but it's possible. Where there's a determination to be close to Jesus, it will become a reality, because he honors and takes note when we get serious about living for God. I want us to notice some interesting things about this. The four friends who were doing the work for the paralyzed man had their faith involved. It is impossible to be a blessing without a blessing splashing all over you as well. It is impossible for you to build up someone's faith without also building up your own. The man's need was out of sight, and unless he got some help from somebody, he was to remain helpless. Unless God chose to act upon his all-knowing ability, Jesus was not going to go in the front yard. Is it not still true that the Lord requires some action from us to get our own blessing? Even if that action requires for us to call for help, the Lord honors effort to please him. If you need help, ask, seek, knock. But by all means, please don't settle for your situation, because God has something better in store for you. He has a miracle in store. The crucifixion of Jesus and the ransom he paid and what you get with your breakthrough is not a situation where you have to choose between either the well-being of your body or the health of your soul. Jesus paid the price for the health of both, and we all can have both. Are you living in the total health that God has provided? God has a miracle for you. The results of that personal miracle are going to bless you, your family, and others you want to come and see God. One of the things that breakthrough does is that it removes blindness and allows you to see like you have never seen before. Before David became the king of Judah and Israel, he was in a great battle. He cried out to the Lord, and the Lord answered him. God gave David a breakthrough that blessed him for the rest of his life. And David messed up big time, but God's mercies and blessings were still with him in many ways. You can't go wrong pursuing your personal breakthrough. I want to encourage you today that in some cases, don't make the Lord do it all, because he's not going to do it all. And if you wait until God does it all, you'll be waiting a long, long time. The thought of the day. It is impossible to be a blessing without a blessing splashing all over you as well. God bless you today. In Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.